This video will present some practical uses of the SUMPRODUCT function for financial or business modeling. We have financial data for various business units across a number of months. Even with the advent of the SUMIF and SUMIFS functions, the SUMPRODUCT function is still a viable alternative to aggregating and computing data because it is incredibly flexible. In this example, we will calculate spot goal revenue in euros based on price, exchange rate, and volume. In summary, here is the formula that computes the 3.3 million euro revenue amount. For the second illustration, SUMPRODUCT will be used to return the total EBITDA for the entire data set. The two ranges of revenue and EBITDA percentage will effectively compute the total EBITDA amount. Here is the formula for the calculation of the total EBITDA figure. The third example will aggregate net income in month two. If the SUMPRODUCT function is applied correctly, then the answer shall be 84. To reiterate, here is the formula version of the SUMPRODUCT used to compute net income for month two. The fourth installation of SUMPRODUCT will derive total net income for the Charlie business unit in month 1 and 4. The double hyphen in front of the first array, which in this case is the business unit column, is pivotal to the successful application of the SUMPRODUCT function in this instance. The second array references the month range of column F. Given we need to reference two values in the month range, months 1 and 4, we need to reference the month column a second time, as we are doing here. Finally, we need to reference column J, or the net income array of data, in order to return the correct amount of 22 for Charlie in months 1 and 4. To confirm, here is the formula again. The fifth illustration of SUMPRODUCT will seek the total revenue for the business units Alpha, Delta, and Echo for month 3. Again, remember to use the double hyphen when referencing the first array, the month range in column F. Similar to the previous formula in example 4, we must reference the business unit range or column B array more than once. Given we want to sum the total revenue for three business units, we have to insert the business unit array three times, as we are doing here. Finally, we reference the revenue array in column G. The correct amount will be 241. To recap, here is the formula again. We will continue this demonstration in a follow-up video where we will look into further uses of SUMPRODUCT in financial modeling. Feel free to send us a comment, like us, or subscribe to our channel.